Dear students, so today let us be study about the topic organolithium and organoberyllium compounds. In the last class, we have studied the metal carbonyls of binuclear compounds. Now these organolithium and organoberyllium compounds can also be explained as preparation properties and structure of metal alkyls and aryls. So let us we study first about alkyl and aryl lithium. So this compound can be prepared by the direct reaction of lithium with alkyl or aryl chloride in benzene or petroleum. When lithium is treated with alkyl chloride in presence of a solvent like benzene, we get the lithium and lithium chloride. If I take an example of ethyl chloride, I get ethyl lithium. Another method is lithium aryls are best prepared by using N-butyl lithium and an aryl iodide in ether. The N-butyl lithium, when it is treated with aryl iodide like phenyl iodide or benzyl iodide in presence of ether, I get phenyl lithium or benzyl lithium and N-butyl iodide. Methyl lithium can also be prepared by exchange through the interaction of N-butyl lithium and methyl iodide in hexane at low temperature. N-butyl lithium, when it is treated with methyl iodide, I get methyl lithium and N-butyl iodide. Coming to the properties of organolithium compounds. Organolithium compounds are thermally unstable and most of them decompose to lithium hydride and an alkene at room temperature. They are generally liquids or low melting solids. They are soluble in non-polar solvents. They react rapidly with oxygen and are spontaneously flammable in air with water and water vapors. Organolithium compounds react with alkyl iodide to give the compounds having C-C bonds or higher alkanes or aranes. When alkyl lithium is treated with alkyl iodide, I get higher alkanes. Similarly, aryl lithium and aryl iodide gives higher aranes. The example, if I take the methyl lithium, when it is treated with methyl iodide, I get ethane. Similarly, ethyl lithium reacts with ethyl iodide gives N-butane. Organolithium compounds react with halogens to give alkyl halides. So when I take the methyl lithium, when it is treated with an halogen, we get methyl halide and lithium halide. Organolithium compounds react with carbon monoxide to give symmetrical ketones. So alkyl lithium, when it is treated with carbon monoxide, gives alkyl carbonyl and a ketone. For example, if I take methyl lithium, gives the acetone. Ethyl lithium gives diethyl ketone. Methyl lithium and butyl lithium are used in organic synthesis as polymerization catalysts and alkylating agents. Coming to the structure of the lithium methyl or methyl lithium. Lithium alkyls are polymeric in nature. Methyl lithium exists as tetrameric. So the four methyl lithium combine to form a polymer or a tetramer. Here there is a tetrahedral set of four lithium atoms with a methyl group placed symmetrically above each three lithium face and methyl group bridging through lithium atoms. The carbon atoms having the coordination number 7 being bonded directly to 3 hydrogen and 4 lithium atoms. The diagram shows the 3 lithium atoms, and above the carbon we have one more lithium from the another set. So hence 4 lithium plus 3 hydrogen of the carbon gives totally the 7, hence the coordination number becomes 7. The lithium carbon bond distance is 231 picometer and lithium lithium bond distance is 268 picometer. Coming to the another, that is organometallic compounds of beryllium. Beryllium dialkyls can be prepared by reacting lithium alkyls or Grignard reagents with beryllium chloride in ether medium. When I take methyl lithium, when it is treated with beryllium chloride in ether, gives dimethyl beryllium and lithium chloride. Similarly, like a Grignard reagent like methyl magnesium chloride, when it is treated with beryllium chloride in ether, gives dimethyl beryllium and magnesium chloride. Beryllium dialkyls can also be prepared by heating beryllium metal with mercury dialkyls in ether medium. When beryllium metal is heated with the dimethyl mercury, we get the dimethyl beryllium and mercury. The alkyls can be collected either by sublimation or by distillation in vacuum. Beryllium dialkyls are colorless solid or viscous liquids of high reactivity, which contain which catch fire on in air and are explosively hydrolyzed by water. Dimethyl beryllium is a polymeric chain. The higher alkyls are less highly polymerized. Coming to the structure of dimethyl beryllium, which is having a polymeric chain. Here, each carbon atom is 5 coordinated. That means each carbon contains 3 hydrogen atoms and the 2 beryllium atoms are arranged in polymeric way. In this, the carbon-beryllium-carbon bond angle is 114 degree and beryllium-carbon-beryllium bond angle is 66 degree. And the carbon and beryllium bond length is 193 picometer. So this is about the organometallic compound of the beryllium. Now coming to the here, I have shown some of the slides, so which gives the other informations than what I have told you. So here, this gives some general characteristics. The organolithium reagents characterized by the carbon-lithium bond are important in organic synthesis as RMGX. Lithium is less electronegative than carbon, and the carbon-lithium bond is polarized as in organomagnesium halide. The organolithium reagents are more reactive than organomagnesium halides, which are nothing but the Grignard reagents, and are expected to behave both as a nucleophile and a base. Here I have shown some of the reactions of the organolithium compounds with alkenes and alkynes. So these are the some of the extra knowledge, so where you can study. In this slide, I have shown some of the reactions like alkyne when it is treated with the lithium amine. So we get the alkyne lithium compounds. So other examples are also given in this slide. Here also I have given some of the formations of alkyl lithium reagents. So these are the reagents, they are generally used as the alkyl lithium compounds and aryl lithium compounds. In this slide, I have shown the structure of the alkyl lithium and alkyl beryllium. Here, I have shown the diagram where each carbon is linked to the three lithium atoms, and fourth one is in the next, what you can say, the crystal. And also the beryllium. Each beryllium is linked to methyl group, and they are the, what you can say, the one is perpendicular to the another one. So one is in the x-axis, another one is in the y-axis, as shown in the diagram. Similarly, we can also explain the alkyl, the metals. And here I have shown the aluminium. So the alkyl aluminium and aryl aluminium, the organometallic compounds, so which have polymeric in a nature. And here I have given the detail about these, the alkyl beryllium and aryl beryllium compounds. Students, go through these the things, and the if you have any doubts, you can ask me in the WhatsApp. Thank you.